These are your rigid edition BFR bands. Before we get started with this video, I just want to go over some tips as it applies to BFR training. So with BFR training, a couple things I want you to be aware of is, number one, what you're trying to do, the goal is to slow blood flow away from the limbs. So you have arteries that carry blood flow in. Arteries are a little bit deeper. So if you apply too much pressure, or if the, you know, if the strap you're using is too narrow and you apply too much pressure, like some of the things I've seen out there, then you could more likely occlude the arterial blood flow, which is what you don't want. The superficial venous blood flow, which are more close to the surface, so superficial means, the venous blood return is what carries the blood out of the limbs, out of the arms or legs. So when you're doing BFR training, the goal is really to only apply the right amount of pressure for the venous occlusion. So you're slowing the blood flow from leaving the limbs. So that's why what I always recommend is, when you're tightening your bands, you want to make sure that you start, if we're talking about a qualitative scale of a scale of 1 to 10, 10 being tightest, you want to start at about a 5 to a 7. And I almost recommend starting a little bit less than you think. A lot of people actually over-tighten, in my opinion, in the beginning, not realizing that anytime you do any strength training, you're actually doing occlusion training. You're occluding blood flow internally anytime you get a pump. So I recommend going a little bit less tight than you think, maybe a number 5 on a scale of 1 to 10, and then do a high volume warm up. Use very lightweight or bands, and you want to do a lot of repetitions, 20, 30 reps or more, and you want to do a lot of sets, 4 to 6 sets or more, with short rest periods, maybe 20 seconds of rest in between sets. And what you'll find is that after you finish that warm up, you'll go from being a 5 to about a 7, so you'll be at optimal pressure. Another thing I highly recommend is just checking throughout the workout, putting your thumb into the palm of the hand, and just looking at how fast the color refills. Optimal pressure, they say, is usually about a 2 to 3 seconds in refill time. If it's less than 2 seconds, that probably means that it's too loose, and if it's more than 3 seconds, that means it's probably too tight. And if at any time you have any numbness, tingling, any pain whatsoever, take the bands off or loosen them, because they're most likely too tight. Another misconception is that you should be wearing the bands closer to the joint if, for example, you're training forearms or calves. It's a big misconception. You actually don't need to do that, and you don't want to do that. There's a lot of nerves near the elbow and near the knee, and you don't want to put pressure on those nerves, so it's not necessary. The other thing about BFR training, the great thing about it, is that it has a systemic effect. And what that means is that when you wear them on the upper arms, for example, even if you train chest and back, you're getting a benefit for chest and back. A lot of people think that it's really just for arms or quads, whatever muscle is closest to where you're actually putting the strap. It's not true. It has a systemic effect. So it's tapping into your brain, which makes changes throughout the body, as well as making changes in your biochemistry, in the blood flow. So just remember, it's not just for biceps and triceps, it's not just for quads and glutes. It actually does have a big benefit for forearms and grip and calves, even when you wear it at the top of the thighs or at the top of the arms. So now let's talk about your specific bands. A couple things I want to point out with this: the entire thing is rigid, so there's no elasticity to this. We designed this specifically for people who wanted something rigid. We found a lot of people liked having something that was more rigid, and that also is very similar to some of the devices, some of the more expensive devices out there on the market that, you know, a lot of the studies were done that were actually rigid devices. And so that's kind of the nice thing about this, is it's very similar to that concept. And the nice thing about this too is that it adjusts to pretty much any arm size. These are 18 inches in length. We also have a leg version, which is 30 inches in length. But they'll pretty much be useful for pretty much anybody who has normal or above normal arm size. The way you want to get this started to put this on is, you want to put this on the upper arm. So you want it to be just below the delt. And you want to take the Velcro. You want to make sure this logo, the hard Velcro here, is pointing towards the body, pointing towards the midline. So that way you can easily pull it towards you. And so you'll see it's very easy to tighten, because as you pull towards you, it starts to automatically tighten. You have a nice, really, really strong, double-stitched metal slider. And to prevent any kind of pinching, you want to make sure to wear over clothing when possible, and tighten slowly. If you pull too quickly, you might pull the skin, you might pinch a little bit. So you have to be very careful, tighten very slowly, wear it over clothing, and you want to tighten it just so that it's comfortable, like we talked about before, a 5 to a 7 on a scale of 1 to 10, and do your thorough warm-up, and then you should reach optimal pressure after that. You'll also notice that this particular model, these rigid bands, we put a nice comfort liner on the inside. So that way you don't have this scratchy Velcro directly on the skin or rubbing against the body, chafing at you. So that should make it very, very comfortable. You should also be receiving via email my free BFR book. It has not only a lot of FAQs to help answer even more of your questions, but also has a full body workout program in there with sets, reps, everything. If you don't receive that via email, please let us know, send us an email, or if you bought your bands on Amazon, go ahead and look up your order in your Amazon account and you can send us a direct message through there and we'll go ahead and attach the ebook and send it to you right through that messaging system. So thanks again, and I hope you enjoy your Rigid Edition BFR bands.